Hey, this is YBR with BeamNG Draft, and today we're going to make some crashes that even Hollywood would be proud of, because these are going to be some explosive crashes for no real reason. We're just going to do stuff just for fun, really. But what we're going to do mostly is we're going to grab a propane tank, right? And we're going to stuff it inside like the engine bay of the car, so that way it looks like the engine itself, to some extent, is exploding when you crash the car. So there's a propane tank, and what we do is just say, here's the engine for the truck, stuff it in there. Just like that. That's perfect. And then when we crash the car, it should look like the actual engine itself is exploding for no real reason. You know, in Hollywood movies, though, engine, fuel tank, whatever, will always explode. So that is the idea here. The engine should explode because explosions. There we go. Look at that. Oh my goodness. That worked great, but that was really explosive. Wow. That was just... Wow. I mean, look at the car! It's ruined! That was great. That is one amazing wreck, you know? That was beautiful. Alright, let's do it a little slower this time, see if it'll work still here. There we go. See, that one wasn't as crazy. I think the other one was just the speed plus the explosion. Really just ruined everything. That one was more like what I expected. You know, it blows up the front end, but the rest of the truck doesn't get blown to bits as well, just the front part. See, that worked a lot better. Maybe not better, but more like what I expected, you know? And let's go. Ooh, I got an idea. What if we do a jump? Will the jump landing it cause the thing to blow up? Like, you're driving your car along, it's leaking fuel all over the place or something, and then your tires are made out of metal, so they spark up. There's the storyline. Oh, I didn't blow it up. I'll make you blow up whether you like it or not. We will blow you up. There's a ramp over there. We're going to use that ramp, and that'll blow it up, hopefully. You might not be able to blow it up like this, because the car itself might absorb too much of the impact with the suspension and all. Unless we don't land flat, you know. If we land, oh, like that, that's going to blow up, probably. That's going to blow up. There's no way. Yep. Ooh, look at that! I told you, man, Hollywood would be proud of something like that. Just blowing things up all over the place. And that one again looks more... That first one was just crazy. I don't even know if it would look... If we did that same thing, will it look the same? Or is it just that one is just like an outlier that just looks insane because it kind of glitched up or something? I want to figure that out. So I think we were going like 50 miles per hour. We just kind of... Just like that, and then... Yeah, that one was just crazy. I don't know how it happened, but the other one was just crazy. This one, it's pretty bad, but not as bad as the other one. Alright, so here's another idea. It's just a slight variation on this. Oops. What if we did it where we tip the propane tank over so it kind of actually hides in the engine bay? Just for, you know, realism's sake, we could do this, and then it'll probably be a little bit more... Oh! That's not how you tip something. How about this? We'll tip it on a ramp. That might be a bit easier. Or, actually, what about these things? That might be perfect. Just set it right... Oh, goodness, not the truck. Get out of here. Crazy truck. So let's put it, like, right there. And reset it. There, perfect. And then we're going to try to actually hide it in the engine bay this time. See if that will work. Just... like... There. I think it worked? It might just be so well hidden, it's perfect. Or it might have disappeared somehow from a glitch. Truthfully, I don't know which. Oh, it is in there. Oh, this is perfect. Oh, this is perfect. Like, you can't see it at all. I should have done this from the start. Oh, this is just yes, 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 yes. So now it'll look like the car itself is actually all, oh. Whoa. Did you hear that? What kind of sound was that? But that worked so perfect. That works so perfectly. I mean, I am so impressed that that worked like as well as it did. It's just beautiful. Oh, that one you can kind of see it a little bit, can't you? I mean, it's not exactly easy to probably do that again. There we go. Look at that, perfectly hidden. You don't know that it's there at all. So you just drive along, and then eventually, boom. So that's what we're gonna do from now on. That's way better than the other way. Oh my goodness, it did blow up that time. It didn't do that last time. It looked like a car just blew up for no reason. The car's like, I'm sick of your crap, I'm blowing up. And it just is done. Right, let's use a different car then and keep doing it like that. I like that way a lot. It just, it adds so much when you actually can't see the tank and it looks like the car itself is actually blowing up. It's just like, that is awesome. So next up, we'll try using this thing, the H Series van. We're going to try to use a little bit of every stock car. Maybe we'll do some modded cars as well. I haven't, you know, really decided yet. So first, we got to tip the tank over. Then we're going to just stuff it into the engine compartment. Yeah, it's a little bit into the driver's... Oh, it's sticking out, though. I don't want that. Come on, get in there good. Ah, oh! Come on, sit. Oh, it might be this engine bay is just smaller. So I can't really... We'll try it one more time. How about if we try it really low? Yeah, that'll work. You can't see it from above. That's all that matters to me. I bet if we tried to do the suspension test, it'll just blow up. That'd be dumb. Let's just test our suspension real quick, make sure our suspension is set up properly, and... Oh my goodness, this suspension is all wrong. When you go over a bump, your car should not blow up. First rule of suspension making. It's like suspension making 101 right there, really. Back it up. Let's roll this tank over. Ooh, it went the wrong way. Ah, who cares? Whoa, car, come back here, stop it. Hey, listen, did you notice? That works. It has like a little funky shape right there, but it's 99% hidden. From the inside, huh, what's that thing right there? I don't know, it's probably nothing, don't worry about it. All right, let's get our deliveries done. We're gonna go deliver something right here. This is where the delivery's at, right? Oh no, I didn't slow down in time. That's okay, it's not like the car's explosive or something. Oh my God, we're dead. That works great. Oh! Oh, look at the way it's gonna land. Land on this glass. Land on the glass. Come on. Land on it. Land on it. Land on it. Oh, come on. Hold on. Hold on. Almost. Oh my God. Somehow the rear wheels will still... Look, I'm putting the throttle and they're still moving, actually. That is impressive. How is that even possible? How is that possible? Like, no way. I can't even find the engine anymore. How is it still working? Where is the engine in this pile of metal? Is that the engine right there? Oh, it's hard to use the camera as well right now because it's the experimental version. That might be the engine right there, part of the engine. It's hard to tell. Maybe we can see it from below. Oh, we can't look from below. Oh, well. Let's just go ahead and get a new car up. We'll do one more blow up with this vehicle, and then we'll try another vehicle. Alright, so let's see, put it right about there. That's gonna be the driver's explosive, not the engine. I mean, I could also do it out like where the fuel tank would be, but meh. I'm happy like this. This way's fun. Yeah, it's just another alternative, though, instead of doing it where the engine is. You can do it where the fuel tank is. That one's perfect. Like, look, you can see it right there. You see, oh my goodness, hey. Hey, what is that? Come on now. Don't... Premature explosions, huh? Ah, well, we'll just set it up again. It's no big deal. So maybe it's like a ticking time bomb to some extent. Should be about... right. I wonder if there's a key to, like, slow down the camera movement, because that would be helpful. But like, right here, it's like, I gotta be so... It's like I tap the key and it goes too far. It's like, I just tap it as light as I can and it's too much. How about that? Perfect. Uh-oh. I don't know if we could drive on these spacers. Oh, no, we cannot. Huh. Oh, great. That is okay. That is not okay. That is absolute destruction. What in the world is... That is a glitch. Plain and simple, that is glitching out right there. Alright. Fall over. Fall over. Fall over. Okay, there we go. And try to put it in the truck. Like, there. Nah, come on. I don't want it sticking out too much. Just a little bit. Oh. So I'm blowing up now. Not yet. Hold on. Just wait a minute. All right, one last try. Tip it. Tip. Oh, I didn't tip. I reset it because I knew it was fragile and was already beat up. So I didn't want to waste it all. Well, just, you know, wherever it is, it is. We can't see it mostly. I'm happy. Now let's blow up this engine. All right, right here should blow it up. All perfect. And that one looked good too. Like, I don't know what happened with that one. That one was just, what was going on there, man? It's crazy. All right, what vehicle should we use next? We'll just go in reverse order. How about that? And we're just sticking to stock vehicles for now. You know, if you wanted to see modded vehicles, we could do that as well. But for now, it's stock. Next up is the Bolide, which actually gets the propane tank put in a very different place. It's in the back, because that's where the engine is. Which, well, I don't know what'll happen for sure. I don't see a propane tank at all, except I do. Oh, the engine just blew up. Look at that thing. It's like I'm a supercar. I can blow up already. I don't think that's going to drive. Hiding it away, it's not exactly worth it, it seems like. Yeah, it's cool when you hide it away, but it seems to blow up a lot easier when you do that. Alright, good enough. Oh, it's stuck in the wheel. Not good enough. This one might not be a good car for this, actually hiding it. If it doesn't work out too well, we could just plop it in. Like that. Yeah, let's just plop it in. Because hiding it does not seem to want to work. So just like that. Just, yeah. It's fine. It's not a propane tank that's going to explode or anything. Don't worry about it. Okay, that looked alright. I can't see anything because the car's upside down. What a pain you are. It looked alright. Maybe we could set it a little lower in the car. It's not it's not Flintstones Mobile where the driver's the engine there. Come on. Put it back a bit. I want it to get a little lower. That's all I want. Just a little bit lower. Not that low. That looks funny though. Alright, well. You know what? Whatever. I'm tired messing with things, trying to get it set up. Let's just blow it up. I don't care. Will it blow up from something like this? Yes, it will. And that does not look anything like the car it used to. Just, nope. Not at all. I'm gonna blow it up. Once it reaches the point. There we go. So you see, boom, the front end is crashing. The propane tank is starting to it's starting to move forward, and then it hits the roof of the car, it looked like. And explosion and glitch explosion a little bit. Oh my goodness. I think you could live through that. No problem. You could, wow, look, it even popped it into the air. I'm pretty sure though you could live through that. Like, I don't see anything that could kill you right there, really. Sure, you'd be, that is assuming, of course, that you were made out of jello or Play-Doh or something where you could be reattached later. And you didn't get blown up. Because if you get blown up, that'd probably have other repercussions that, you know. Let's not think about that. Let's just use the sunburst! Oh, jeez, I put the propane tank as the car. Oh, well. We can just get another propane tank. And, well, hey, look, it's already in there. That's not what I meant to do at all. Shh, don't tell nobody. Alright, so, careful, around there. Perfect. Oh, but it's blocking a wheel. Oh, come on. Come on, go! I know what we could do. We can use some wind to fix this. So I think the command, I should really, like, write this down. I had to look it up real quick because I'm like, I don't know the wind command off the top of my head. Alright, that's wrong direction, so we do negative 250. Oh, gee. The friction. like the tires when they rubbed against the propane tank. And now the wind's just shoving it along as anyways. Oh, we're just we're gonna blow that thing up. Alright, let's stop being fancy. I think fancy only works with cars where they have big engine bays like the truck. Really? You know, something simple like that? That works too. You know, it works perfectly fine. Yes. I like the way that one looked. Actually, this car doesn't even have an engine, does it? No, it's not finished. Let's go ahead and skip to the next car then. How about we go to... Oh yes, this one we could shove the thing in, no problem. I mean, if I have trouble hiding a propane tank thing in this, I got issues. I mean, look how easy this is. What propane tank? Oh. Well, it was not quite hidden. Now it is. 99%? I'm happy with 99%. Okay, then. Wow. I can't... Where'd my truck go? I had a truck here a while ago. Seems to have just disappeared on me. Whoop. And goodbye, truck. It just ruins the thing. Like, this car gets ruined way worse than the others. It must be because the tank is so in there, so it's buried so deep, all of the force is really absorbed by the car, where the other ones... Oh my... We couldn't even go up the ramp that time! But I was just saying, with the other cars, like, some of the explosion kind of goes around the car. This one, it really just eats the explosion and takes it. Whoa, we didn't blow up. I want to blow up, though. There we go. Poor vehicle. Alright, let's do the next vehicle. We'll do one more and that's it, maybe. One more vehicle. Pigeon, it won't fit. Well, hey, we'll do pigeon anyways. Who cares if it don't fit? Actually, I don't know if we'll be able to actually control the vehicle. Where is the engine in this thing anyways? Isn't it, like, in an odd position? Or is it not? Oh, I guess it's in a normal spot. It's just so small. Look how tiny it is. Shut the propane tank in it. That's good enough. Let's see, can we actually... Oh, we can go left and right still. That's great. And... Oh? Huh? Eh? It's supposed to blow up, you know? Oh, what is this? The unbreakable propane tank all of a sudden? I will blow you up. As long as I can drive, you will blow up. It's probably just gonna blow up when I don't expect it. Like, I'm gonna just be driving right here and boom! Alright, here we go. 30 miles per hour. There's no way it's not gonna blow up. Are you serious? Are you serious? It didn't blow up still? Where'd all these crumple zones come from? Because apparently this car is just saving the life of this propane tank over and over. That is ridiculous. This thing should have blown up. Blow up, you pain in the butt. Come on. Yes. There we go. Now I'm happy. Where'd the other half of the car go? I don't know. Let's find it. Oh my goodness, there are pieces of the car all over the place. Oh, it's right here. But some pieces, they went on a vacation. They're way over there. Alright, let's do it again. I want on the first crash this time, though. Whoa. Something just broke. Like, the screen said, just beam has broken, and then all of a sudden we can't control the car anymore. Well, okay then. Okay, propane tank is trying to drive now. No propane tank, you just sit in the car and be happy. I don't know why it's in the driver's seat, I have no idea. I guess it just does whatever it wants, you know? It's too hard to control it with the propane tank, it seems like. It doesn't really drive the way it would normally drive. I don't know, like, it's... Do you see? I'm not churning right. I'm churning left. But the tire's stuck in the... Yeah, let's just go... Oh, okay, it blew up right as I hit reset. Thanks. I'm just gonna go ahead and switch to a new car. Because that one's weird. The way it's working, it's just weird. Zoom out a bit. Stuff it in the engine bay! Well, okay, on the engine bay works too. This one won't do much damage at all, but we'll try it anyways. I say much damage at all, but that's still probably gonna kill you, you know? If you're the driver, you're dead. I just mean in comparison to the other ones where it just obliterates the car, you know? Ah. I should probably just use the map editor for this, but it's too late now. I've done all of it this far. Like this. We'll just finish it like this. Oh, yes, we're popping a wheelie in my front-wheel drive vehicle. Oh, look. How convenient. I didn't have to do anything at all. Yeah, it is ruined. Stop it. Stop it. Oh, my goodness. Will you please stop? There. That's perfect. That is actually perfect. Let's blow you up! What? What? Come on. It's supposed to be explosive. Not wimpy, wimpy, pathetic stuff. Explosive. Yes. That's it? That's it? Shoot, I think that almost reduced the damage. Like, the way we hit things, it kind of just reduced the damage almost. You know, that's a good test. Will running into a propane tank at a high speed do more or less damage than a wall? We'll maybe try that some other video. Gonna go and end this one here with a very, very stretched out piece of glass that looks ridiculous. Doesn't even look like the same car anymore. It looks like some futuristic concept car, you know? But anyways, till next time, this has been YBR. I'll see ya.